In this video, we'll be finding the sum of an arithmetic series. Now, just as a reminder, I have two examples down here of an arithmetic series and a geometric series, just so that you can see the difference between the two. In this arithmetic series example, we have 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus 14, and so on and so forth. And you can see that each term, we start with the number 2, and then each term subsequent to the number 2 is generated by adding the number 3. That's 2 plus 3 is 5, plus 3 is 8, plus 3 is 11, and so on and so forth. When compared to a geometric series, look how we still start with the number 2, but the series is generated as 6, 18, 54, 162 after that. And that's because we're not adding by 3, but we are instead multiplying by 3. So 2 times 3 is 6, times 3 is 18, times 3 is 54, and so on and so forth. And the biggest difference between arithmetic series and geometric series is that geometric series, they tend to grow much faster than arithmetic series do. So we're going to be finding the sum of an arithmetic series in this video. I've already done a video on finding the sum of a geometric series, so if you're interested in that topic, then I recommend going to check that out, and I'll put a link in the description below. To find the sum of an arithmetic series, we are going to apply this formula. S of n is equal to the sum of a of 1 plus a of n all over 2 times n, where a of 1 is the first term of the series. So a of 1 right here, if we were using this arithmetic series, that would be the number 2. So I'd put 2 right here. Plus a of n. A of n is the last term of the series. So if this were a finite series, whatever the last term would be in this series, I'd put that number right here. And n is the number of terms in the series. So you count up the number of terms in the series, and that would be your n that goes right here and also right here. And we're going to take a look at three examples in which we are going to apply this formula. The first example is when we are given sigma notation. Here we are given the summation of 4 times k plus 2, as k goes from 1 to 807. And we are going to find the sum of that sigma notation expression by using this formula that we just saw on the previous page. In order to apply this formula, I need to have three variables, and I need to find their values. Those three variables are n, a of 1, and a of n. And do we have those three variables? Well, in fact, we do. N is equal to 807. Remember what n is? That's the number of terms. If k goes from 1 to 807, well, that's a total of 807 terms. So I'm going to place 807 here and here. The second thing we have is a of 1. A of 1 is the first term. Well, to find the first term of 4k plus 2, I start with k is equal to 1. I plug 1 into this k. 4 times 1 plus 2. I'll do that quick calculation and I get 6. That means a of 1, or my first term, is going to be the number 6. And so 6 will go right here into this position, a of 1. And finally, we have a of n. A of n is the last term in the series. Well, if I find the first term by plugging in a 1, how do I find the last term? Well, I take the last number in this series, which is 807. We plug that number into k here. A of n is now equal to a of 807, which is equal to 4 times k is 807 plus 2, which is equal to 3,230. That is the last term in this finite series. And that number is going to go right here. So we're going to plug those numbers in. We have S of 807 is equal to 6 plus 3,230 divided by 2 times 807. And if I do my calculations correctly, then I should get my answer of 1,305,726. Now remember what this number represents. If I were to list out the first 807 terms of this series, they would all sum to the number 1,305,726. Let's look at a second example. This time we are not given sigma notation, we are given a sum expression. This series here starts with the number 3, and then we add 9, then we add 5, and we keep on adding and adding and adding until we reach our final term in this finite series of 2,403. And I'm going to find the sum of this series by applying the formula that we've seen a couple of times now. And in order to apply this formula, I need three things. I need to find out what n is, what a of 1 is, and what a of n is. And in this case, we are given a first term, and we are given a last term. So in this case, I know what a of 1 is, and I know what a of n is. So 3 is going to go right here, and 2,403 is going to go right here. It's now my job to find n. Remember what n is. N is the number of terms in this series. Now, as we go from 3 to 9 to 15, notice that there are a lot of numbers missing in between this 15 and this 2,397. So how can I find the number of terms in this series? Well, I can keep on following the pattern. As I go from 3 to 9, remember that this is an arithmetic series, and so I'm adding the same number each time. 3 plus 6 will give me 9, plus 6 will give me 15, plus 6 will give me 21 and 27, and so on and so forth. And even at the end here, look, as we get to 2,397, we would add 6 to that in order to get to 2,403. So 6 is what we call our common term. In order to find n, we are first going to find the range of our series here. So I'm going to take the last term and I'm going to subtract the first term from it. 2,403 minus 3 is 2,400. That is my range. I'm going to take that range and I'm going to divide it by the common term. We said that 6 is the common term because that's the number that we keep adding in order to get from number to number to number. And when we do 2,400 divided by 6, that equals 400. That 400 is the amount of times that we add 6 in order to get to this last term. So we start with the number 3. We add 6, we add 6, we add 6, and we add 6 400 total times in order to get to 2,403. That's what this number means. But remember that as we add that number 6, that does not account for the first term. So there aren't 400 terms. There are actually 400 plus that first term we now have to include. So that is a total of 401 terms. And that's my n. My n, or the amount of terms total, is 401. So I have 401 is n, a of 1 is 3, and a of n is 2,403. I plug those numbers into my formula like so, and I calculate to get an answer of 482,403. Remember what this number represents. If I were to take all these terms in this series and add them all together, this would be the sum that I get. Finally, one more type of problem here. What if you were given a recursive formula? So here's your recursive formula. You're given a of 1 is equal to negative 56, and a of I is equal to a of I minus 1 plus 2.5. Now remember how to read this. Negative 56 is your first term, and every term subsequent to that you will generate by adding 2.5 to the term previous. So negative 56 plus 2.5 will give you your next term. Plus 2.5 will give you the next. Plus 2.5 will give you the next, and so on and so forth. Your job is to find the sum of the first 2,187 terms. So we're going to, again, apply this formula to this series here. But we need those three things, n, a of 1, and a of n. What do you have? Well, you have a of 1, that's the first term, negative 56, and that's going to go right here. A of n, you also have, you have n. N is 2,187 terms in total. So 2,187 will go right here and right here. So I have A of 1 and I have N, but I do not have A of N. A of N is the last term in the series. I'm given the first term and I'm told how to find all the other ones. But do you really want to add 2.5 2,186 times in order to get the 2,187th term? No, you're not going to list all those terms out. So instead of writing this formula recursively, we're actually going to rewrite it explicitly. Remember that an explicit formula will find any term in the series or sequence at any given time. And your explicit formula is, if you want to find any term in this sequence or series, that's equal to the first term plus the common term times n minus 1. So in this case, n is going to be 2,187, because that is the 2,187th term, or the final term in this series. That's equal to the first term, which is negative 56, plus the common term, which was given to us here, is 2.5. In for n, well, we know what n is. It's 2,187, and that goes right there, minus 1. And if you calculate this, we'll get 5,409. So my 2,187th term, or my last term in this series, is 5,409. I now have a of 1, I have n, and I have a of n. So I'm going to plug those numbers in to my formula like so. And when I calculate this out, I should get an answer of 5,853,505.5. And that is how you find the sum of an arithmetic series given recursive formula, sum expressions, and sigma notation. If you found this helpful, and I very much hope that you did, please let me know in the comments below, and thank you for watching.